Good morning. Who is the elect lady that John is talking about? Today we're starting a new epistle. This little epistle near the very end of the New Testament called 2 John, the second letter of John. Just a short one, almost right before the book of Revelation. So there's only going to be a few of these, so don't blink. Let's hear verses 1 to 3. The elder, to the elect lady and her children, whom I love in truth, and not only I, but also all those who have known the truth, because of the truth which abides in us and will be with us forever. Grace, mercy, and peace will be with you from God the Father and from the Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of the Father, in truth and love. So the epistle of 2 John was written probably about AD 95, thereabouts. This is almost certainly by the apostle John, who was the longest living of the original apostles, and by now the other apostles are pretty much long gone and dead, but John will be alive, and so to be referred to as simply the elder might be something they were doing. So we think it was by John. The language is certainly very similar to the Gospel of John and the Book of Revelation and then the other epistles of John. This is written to the elect lady, and there's a question about who that is. Is it a lady with her actual literal children, or is this referring to a church congregation? As we go through it, we'll look at every single line. It seems very much that this is written to a group of believers. So the elect lady is almost certainly a congregation. It's some small local church somewhere out there in Asia Minor somewhere. And John is writing to this congregation of believers in Jesus Christ. John is going to put the focus on deceivers and antichrists. But first of all, he's going to deal with truth in the first couple of verses here. Unlike this disastrous downward spin cycle, everything is relative to everything else that's current in the Western world today, where there is no ultimate truth. It's just your experiences and my experiences, and John says there's truth. He believes that there is an absolute truth. And of course, Jesus is the truth. He refers to him in his gospel as Jesus being the way, the truth, and the life. He is the example man. He is the model man. He is God himself, also come in human flesh, and he shows us how we need to be living as humans. And so he is the ultimate model. And he's not something far out there and impossible for us, but instead he's showing us exactly how our lives can be optimal if we live within the moral framework that this universe, that actually is what this universe is. The truth is the inspired teachings about Jesus and about God, the world that God created, found here in the Bible, and of course it's also Jesus himself. God designed humans, and Jesus came and died on the cross to transform us, to have our sins forgiven, our rebellion transformed, and have us to be changed, and to be able to live with him eternally. But we still get to choose him. He gave us free choice. He gave angels and man free choice. And so this is the gospel. This is God's message to us, and then it's our choice whether we accept it or reject it. He doesn't force us to accept it. He is a loving creator who desires us to be with him in joy forever. So John knows there's another agency at work to deceive and destroy. And someone who is the very opposite of Jesus or goes in the place of Jesus, an antichrist. We'll be talking about that. Let's pray together. Dear Father in heaven, we thank you for the truth that you've put into the Bible, the truth that will show us how we should live. You are the designer. We are the designed. Yes, earth has fallen into rebellion because you gave free choice and it was misused, but you're working to bring us back if we're willing. And so, Lord, help us to be willing. Help us to seek you. And as we carry on in this short series and as we learn more about deceivers and antichrists and their plans to destroy the things that you were trying to build up, help us, Lord, to be like John, and to appreciate that there is an objective truth, the truth outside of ourselves that isn't dependent on whether we agree with the facts or not. And so, Lord, help us to live in that universe, and then show us how to love in this universe, Lord, and be loved. Thank you for hearing our prayer. In Jesus' name, amen. So John writes a short epistle, a short letter to a little congregation, and they need to abide in Jesus and in his truth. So do we. Have a wonderful day in the Lord Christ Jesus.